In this video, I'm going to show you guys how to use the file section in PowerPoint and a couple of key features that you might not already know. So without further ado, let's get started. Alright, so for the font section, if you see here on slide one, I just have a picture of a girl blowing snowflakes in the air. Totally irrelevant to what we're actually trying to learn here, but let's say we're trying to add some text here. So we're just going to say sample text goes here. So I got my sample text in here, and now if we go here up to this font section, you'll see this is what the font actually is for this text. I could have possibly some other font right here, so let's say sample text with other font. And as you can see here, this is Calvary body, and right here it's Calvary light heading. So all you have to do in order to figure out what font you're using is select the font, and then I'll show right here what the font actually is. So let's say you want to change the font. Simple. All you have to do is go to the text box that you want to change the font, highlight it. You can double click, which I didn't, or you can highlight it this way by just clicking and holding, or even do Control A to highlight everything in that text box. Then go to this drop down arrow, and now it's going to give you a bunch of different fonts that you can pick from right here. Now, as I go through each one of these fonts, you're going to see here that's actually showing up on this right. So that way I can see what type of font I'm using and also how it's going to look before I select it without having to actually select it, go back in and change it. This is a really nice preview feature that PowerPoint offers for you. Now, you can also download unique fonts that aren't already included in PowerPoint as a default. If you are interested in doing that, let me know in the comments down below and I can show you guys a video on how to download your own fonts and how to save them in PowerPoint. So a font that I really like that PowerPoint didn't include originally is called Lato. And if you can see here, I have Lato right here. So this is one of my go-to fonts. It's just nice and clean and modern. So that's why I really like using Lato font for slides. It just makes the whole deck look really nice. So another thing to note with this font section is you have a bunch of these features right here. So let's say we want to bold the text. Simple. We could hit this bold feature right here, and now the text is bolded. We can also do Control B to bold the text if we didn't want to have to go all the way up here to do it. Same thing with italicizing. We can hit this, or we can do Control I to do the same feature. For underline, we can hit it right here, or we can do Control U. All right, so now for this S section right here, this is actually text shadow. So if I highlight all my text or just hitting Control A, we'll do the same functionality and then hit this S button. It's gonna add a text shadow, and I'll show you guys right here. This is the shadow it added. So it's just that shadow right there. And then let's say I get rid of the text shadow. It's now not gonna have that shadow anymore for this text. And I can do this for this entire text box if I don't want the shadow to show up anymore. So I'm just going to undo that real quick. Next, we have this strike through text. So let's say I highlight all this and then I hit strike through. Now my entire text is striked through with a line. And let's say you're trying to edit someone's deck and you want to tell them maybe to delete some text. This is a nice way to do it. Another thing that I actually love to use is this functionality right here, character spacing. So what's really cool about character spacing is that it allows you to change up the spacing in between each one of your letters. So if I hit this, I'm gonna have this drop down menu and I have very tight, so it's gonna make the text really smushed in, or I can do just tight, it's less smushed in, normal, which it is at right now, loose, a little bit more spaced out, very loose, which I love to use sometimes to just really dress it up, and then more spacing. So let's say you don't have a feature that's showing right here that you like, you can make it even more spaced out than what very loose is, or even more condensed than what very tight is by just clicking on more spacing. And right here, if I click on it, you'll see here, all you have to do in order to change the spacing is change it right here. And then just choose whatever number of spacing you want. You may have to play around with it, but once you find the amount you would like, then you can hit okay, and it'll do that spacing for you. The next thing I also want to show you guys is this drop-down arrow. So a lot of times I'll catch people trying to fix their mistakes is, let's say they forgot to capitalize each letter in that sentence, or they want to make everything uppercase or everything lowercase. You don't have to retype everything. This is the feature for you for this. So let's say I hit this drop-down menu and I do set in case. Now what it's going to do is it's going to only make that first letter capitalized. So let's say I had it like this, because it was already capitalized to begin with, and I hit sentence case. Now that S is now capitalized. Now let's say I want it all capitalized. I can go back here and do uppercase. Everything's now uppercase, everything lowercase, capitalize each word, or toggle case. So this is a really great way to quickly change the capitalization, lowercase, and whatever styling you like without having to retype out the same sentence, which I really love. Next for the font section is this right here. So to increase and decrease fonts, you can hit this and it's going to decrease it. You hit this and it's going to increase it. I actually never use those two buttons. What I actually do is I'll do Control Shift greater than symbol to increase the text and Control Shift less than to decrease the size of the text. So the same feature is available right here, but I would recommend trying to memorize those tricks with the Control Shift greater than or less than to increase and decrease the text. Another thing that they have in the font section is this highlight feature. So let's say your text isn't highlighted and you just click on this, and then you can highlight it this way. Not sure how often you're going to be using the highlight feature, but is there if you are ever interested in that? You can also say stop highlighting, is let's say you're highlighting a bunch of things and then all of a sudden you don't want this highlight to show up anymore. Just hit this drop down menu, stop highlighting, and now it'll go away. Another way to get rid of it is if you do no color and then you can re-highlight it, and that's how it'll get rid of it. And then again, you could do stop highlighting and it'll get rid of it. Next is how to actually change the font color. So I know this is a pretty common thing to know, but I'm just going to show you guys anyway and how to make it unique colors that are not already showing up as a selection. So let's say I highlight this. You have this whole feature here to pick font color, but I'm going to show you guys up here as well. It's another feature to change the font color, and you can change it to whatever color you want that's showing right here, and you can see a preview of it. Or you can go to more colors and hit one of these standard colors, or even a custom color if you see right here. And not only that, you can even do an eyedropper tool. So let's say you want a certain color on this slide, you can pick it right there, and now it's going to mimic that same color. You can even do it right here and mimic, let's say you want this red. There you go. It's kind of hard to see on this slide in particular, so I can even do eyedropper tool and make it like this gray. That's a little easier to see. So another thing I want to show you guys with this font color is that they're also going to show you recent colors that you picked right here with the eyedropper tool. So as you're starting to pick colors that you really like, they're going to show you the colors right there, so you don't have to re-pick them in the future, which is a really nice feature. Another feature that a lot of people seem to forget about with this font section is this function right here, clear all formatting. So if I highlight all this text and then I click this, it's going to put it back to that plain old simple text that I started with no strike through, no shadows, no italicized, no bolding, no nothing. It's just going to clear everything that you did to format it and go back to the original styling of that text, which is really nice if you ever want to do a little bit of a reset and go back to how it was originally. Lastly, that a lot of people forget about is hitting this expand icon right here, and this will allow you to really dive even deeper into using the font section. Some of these are a little repetitive to what's up here, but some aren't. So let's say you want a strike through, you can do that. You can do a double strike through. So you also have to make sure your text is selected when doing this. So let's say I want to do a double strike through, hit OK. Now I have two lines going through that text. I can highlight this text again, hit the expand icon, and then I can do a superscript. And then if I hit that, now it's a smaller text and it's superscripted upwards. I can also do that with a subscript, offset 30%, small caps, all caps, equalize character height. Feel free to play around with all these different things here, but just know that if you do hit that expand icon, it gives you all these different features right here for you, which is really nice to know if you ever want to take your fonts a step further in terms of how you want to stylize them. So that is everything within the font section in PowerPoint. If you guys did find this helpful, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate it. It's free to do, so please help me out with that. Also, if you guys are interested in learning more about PowerPoint, I actually offer a course on Udemy that teaches all things related to PowerPoint. So I'll have a link to that in the description below. But without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in future videos. Thanks.